In today's session, we will be discussing about inheritance, visibility modes, and the different types of inheritance which are supported in C++. So, starting with what is inheritance? The capability of a class to derive the properties and characteristics from some another class is called as inheritance. It is one of the most important features of object-oriented programming which makes it so popular. It helps for reusing the code, and this reduces a lot of time of development and rework. There are two terminologies related to inheritance. First is called as a subclass. The class which inherits the properties from another class is called as a subclass or derived class. And second terminology is superclass, that is the class whose properties are inherited by another class, that is the subclass, is called as a superclass. Some books you may also find that a subclass is called as a derived class or a child class, and a superclass is called as a base class or the parent class. Next is visibility modes and its effects in the inheritance. So there are three visibility modes which you can make use of while inheriting the classes in C++. The first mode is a private mode. In this particular mode, the members which are in the protected and the public section of the base class will become the private members of the derived class. Second visibility mode is protected. If you are inheriting a child class from the parent class using this mode, then it means that the protected and public members of the base class will become the protected members in the child class. Third visibility mode is public visibility mode. In this, the protected members of the base class become the protected members of the derived class, and public members of the base class become the public members of the derived class. In no case are the private members inherited. So remember this in mind, that from any of the classes, none of the private members can be inherited by the derived class. They are only the protected and public members which can be inherited. And if you are inheriting it in a private way, then they will become the private members. If you are inheriting it in a protected way, then both the public and protected will become the protected members in derived class. If you are inheriting it using the public visibility, then the protected will become protected and public will become public in the derived class. So this was about the visibility modes. Next is, how do we implement the inheritance in C++? The syntax I am discussing over here, that is, you need to give the keyword class. Then you need to give a name to your subclass, that is your subclass or a derived class or the child class. Then you have to make use of a colon. After that, you have to specify the access mode, that is the visibility mode. Okay, so it can be private, protected or public. And after that, you need to mention the name of the base class or the parent class from which you are inheriting this class. And once you have done this declaration, you can start with the body of the class, and here you can write down the code that you wish to write in your derived class, and this is the normal ending of a class. So this is the way in which you can implement inheritance in C++. Now let us see the different types of inheritance supported by C++. The first one is single inheritance, second is multiple, third one is hierarchical, fourth one is multi-level, and fifth one is hybrid inheritance. Some may also refer to as a virtual inheritance. So starting with the first one, that is single inheritance. It is the simplest type of inheritance in which one derived class inherits only from one base class. Okay. So here I am having a subclass B, and this has been derived from a superclass A. So there is just one-to-one relationship, and such type of inheritance is called as a single inheritance. Second is multiple inheritance. In this, you are having more than one parents from which the child is being derived. Okay? So you are having a class C which is being derived from a class A as well as class B. So whenever a derived class has more than one base classes, Such kind of inheritance is called as multiple inheritance. Next is hierarchical inheritance. In this type of inheritance, the multiple derived class inherits from a single base class. So in this case, you may have a hierarchy of inheritance, like for example, B, C, D are derived from A, and so this type of inheritance is called as a hierarchical inheritance. And last one is the multi-level inheritance. That is, these are pure forms of inheritance. In multi-level inheritance, you have a similar type of structure where one class is derived from another and another is derived from third one. So in this example, you can see C class has been derived from B and B has been derived from A. So whenever you have such levels of inheritance, then that is called as multi-level inheritance. And the last one is a hybrid inheritance. Hybrid inheritance in simple terms is nothing but a combination of one or more inheritance. So you can see here that we can see that D class has been derived from B and C. So this is an example of multiple inheritance, but B and C have been derived from A. So this also represents a hierarchical inheritance. So whenever you combine two or more types of inheritance into a single one, that is called as a hybrid inheritance. So that was it for today. Thank you.